Paul?
Gruesome.
I have more edits to do.
Maybe you should see someone.
To quiet my mind. This was a mixed media about a man that was coping with a loss.
I am obsessed with this film. That's why I'm so quick to raise my hand. I thought everything about it was beautiful. Like, it's one of those films that I don't care what anybody thinks. Like, I was so in love with it. Just the way that it was done, how out of the box it was and abstract. Especially the dialogue and the actor, his eyes had so much depth. Like, oh my gosh, I loved that film. Especially, yes, it was dealing with a suicide or a death loss, but it just spoke so many messages about any type of loss and that everyone goes through it. And I don't know, I connected with it so well, and I loved it.
Yeah, imagine thought versus, you know, perceived memory. You know, what's real and what's not.
Sometimes, like when we write, like I'm a poet, you write things that you can't express, so you draw them. So he painted orange, which represent that she was gone, she was leaving. Paul, he cheated on her, and he did it wrong. So he couldn't deal with himself that he had did something so to someone that loved him so much. He went back over and over again of the things that they had done, the dances, the foods, the movies, the first time they kissed, and then he realized that he had did something that caused him to lose the most precious thing in his life, and all he could do was sit there and paint colors.
That's a very interesting interpretation. I only viewed the one woman, so.
She said, you cheated on me, did you cheat on me?
Totally. That's the whole point of this, is to see the different perspectives, what everyone gets. Just from what I found, or at least what I gathered, was there's actually a loss through military, and the idea is how do the survivors deal with that loss, and what do you remember in your head versus what do you feel versus what actually happened? But I think that's totally interesting to hear and to see something differently and then to run with it. So no, I appreciate totally your feedback.
I thought real quick because she said.
It's totally up to what you got. Yeah, I don't want to say that what you perceived or what you gathered is wrong from what that's what you got from it. Everybody could get something different. That's kind of how I perceived
it. I thought it was very, very nice.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Very just intriguing film experience. It was, the visuals are amazing. Like, I could see through his eyes, like you mentioned. And I really like how it can, like when dealing with loss, the pain doesn't really go away. You just learn to live and you deal with it less and less as you know, with time. So it really spoke to me and I just completely enjoyed this film. I think this was my favorite.
We need sleep.
Oh, we'll feel messed up.
We need sleep.
I need you to come home.
I need sleep. I have more edits to do.
Yeah, I actually found this film very breathtaking because it goes to show you how much people hold things dear to them. And sometimes when those things are taken away from them, the color in their life and the motivation that people get to get inspired to do things, it just plain and simple just fades away. And it showed you that his motivation in his life and what motivated him to do art was her. And when she was gone, there was no more art, there was only her. And now it was like an obsession that he had to get over with. But he couldn't because it was his motivation. But yeah, I found it very breathtaking.